Two landmark abortion laws put Nebraska in the national spotlight. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Brady Peterson. Governor Dave Heineman signed both bills today. Most abortions are now illegal past the 20th week of pregnancy.
Women now have to undergo pre-abortion screenings to see if they may be at risk of developing mental or physical problems later.
They're two of the strictest abortion laws in U.S. history. KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live with tonight's big story.
Both pro-life and pro-choice advocates are reacting strongly to these bills tonight. Pro-choice advocates say the laws are onerous. They consider them bound to face a long court battle. Pro-lifers say the new laws reflect general public sentiment and will stand up, they believe, to legal challenges.
Pro-choice forces fought against it a lot.
Two different sides.
Nebraska Right to Life is really pleased.
Two different but perhaps equally strong reactions, both to this scene that unfolded inside the Capitol in Lincoln Tuesday morning.
This is important legislation.
Nebraska Governor Dave Heineman signs into law two new abortion measures, LB 1103 and LB 594. The former banning the procedure after 20 weeks into pregnancy, the latter requiring doctors to assess a woman's mental and physical health before an abortion. Tuesday night.
So there's going to be a legal battle, and I don't think it'll pass muster.
The 20-week law, known as the Fetal Pain Bill, drew much of the focus from pro-choice activists, including the National Organization for Women's Erin Sullivan. Her sentiment, a court challenge is inevitable and may entangle the state for some time.
It's going to take as long as it takes.
We feel that the state does have a compelling interest to come in and protect those unborn children.
Pro-life advocates like Julie Schmidt-Albin, who was on hand for the signing today, say they're aware that a legal challenge is likely ahead for 1103, but she believes it will hold up in court. As she says, evidence from medical advances back up the fetal pain argument.
Fetal surgery and 4D ultrasound has provided a window into the womb now.
Now, Sullivan says her side is not done fighting.
The rallying has begun.
While Schmidt-Albin frames Tuesday's signing as a landmark.
It was a bold move.
As for LB 594, requiring women seeking abortions to undergo health screening, Sullivan called it a, quote, added burden for women. Schmidt-Albin on the pro-life side said it would give women more information on potential risk associated with abortion. Reporting live in Omaha, Todd Andrews, KETV News Watch 7.